In this video, we're going to talk about issues you may face when you use IMPORTRANGE function to get data from different spreadsheets and how you can actually address those. So for example, if we have this spreadsheet with this data, if we wanted to grab some of this data and move it to this spreadsheet right here, we would have used IMPORTRANGE function. So what I would do here, I would do equals IMPORTRANGE. And then we need to follow this by the URL of the spreadsheet in quotes. So I'll do double quotes here, go to this other spreadsheet, copy this link and paste it right here. And then we follow by a comma, and then we have to do the range as string. So if we do double quotes here, we need to refer to a range of cells we want to basically extract from the other spreadsheet. So we want to start with the name of the tab. So here, if we look at this data, the name down here is transactions. So we're going to type transactions, exclamation sign. And then we're going to follow that by the range. And the range is going to be, let's say we want to grab this column B and then also this column F. So for now, let's get column B. So that would be B1 colon all the way down. So I'm going to go ahead and do B1 colon B. Now, if you wanted to go to a particular range, let's say 4 rows going down, you would type B4. But I want to go to a whole column. So I'll just do this, remove the end and hit enter. And what's going to happen now, it's going to ask me to give access to that spreadsheet. So if I click on this, see allow access. And now I was able to get that column B here. Now, say I also wanted to get the sales amounts from F column. So I could just simply now copy this, hit escape, go back and paste it here and replace this B with F. Now, if you want to get multiple columns, you can do multiple columns here in your range. For now, I'll do this, hit enter. Now, this is great. Now, one of the issues that you may have with IMPORTRANGE is when you have this spreadsheet, you may or may not want people who access this spreadsheet to be able to see the data on this spreadsheet. So you may want them to be able to see the sales and sales rep data, but it's possible that you don't want them to be able to access cost of goods sold data. Now, if you just share the spreadsheet, if they have added access, anybody could just go here and update these ranges to anything they want. So they could go from F through G, hit enter, and now you get access to pretty much anything you want from the other spreadsheet. So for that reason, if we want to limit the access to a particular part of this, what we're going to do, we're going to use this as an intermediate spreadsheet. So what we'll do, we'll simply just go here and rename this tab. I'll just call this whatever you want to call it. You can call it the same transactions if you want, but I'll just go ahead and name it something else so you can see the difference. So I'll just call it sales data. And now what we're going to do, we're going to basically create another spreadsheet. This is the one we're going to share. And on this one, I'm going to do another import range from here. So what I'll do import range. Again, spreadsheet URL in quotes. So this time it's going to be this spreadsheet. So we'll copy that, go here and paste, comma. Then we do range as string again. So this time the name of the tab was sales data, exclamation sign. So that's this sales data worksheet right here. And the range is going to be from A1 through B all the way down. So I'll do A1 colon B. And if I hit enter, again, we're going to have to give access to that. So now we give access and we can share this spreadsheet, But now, even if we go and change the range in this one to any other column, it doesn't really matter because in this spreadsheet, that's pretty much all the info we have. So by using the spreadsheet in the middle, we basically restrict access to the rest of our data that's coming from the original data spreadsheet. So that's one reason to do this. And the second reason to do this is once you allow access to a spreadsheet, there's really no way to disallow access, at least at this point of time. So this is why having the spreadsheet in the middle is again a good idea, because now I could basically just go ahead and delete this spreadsheet in the middle if I wanted to, and that way it will disallow access to that data and I don't have to touch my actual source spreadsheet. So that's a little bit about import range, and that should do it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and I'll see you in the next one.